Hi everybody, I'm Kirsten Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a nail that is literally on fire. Well, maybe we'll put it out actually. But there's going to be fire involved and there's going to be a bit of burntness involved. But it's going to be beautiful. I've already pre-burnt some paper, and I've burnt some tissue as well, because I wasn't sure which one I'm going to use, and I might use a bit of both, to be honest with you. I think it'll give it a good texture. So all I literally did was, where's my other paper gone? I just literally ripped some paper.
Do we need to put a disclaimer on this?
And just gently burnt the edge. So you get that. Whoa! Yeah, so you get this kind of burnt edge. With this one, you see this, how it's got a lot more burntness to it. That was put on the cooker. That was Adam's idea. We just put it on the ring. So it just smouldered up a little bit more, whereas this is more on the actual edge, which is quite pretty. Oh, it's still burning. Yeah, so I don't know if you need to try this at home if you are under the age of 18. You may need adult supervision. Well, I think adult supervision would be recommended, even for me. Thank God I have Adam with me. And then with the paper towel, you've got to be really careful with this, because it doesn't take much to go up in flames like this. Oh my God. Why is it not stopping? Oh, that's okay. Right, so yeah. So it's, you know, you might want to do it outside, where you're not going to burn your house down. However, it works really nicely. So you want to gather all your little bits and tear them. You want to sort of tear the pieces off because you want to have a rough edge. So if we look at this, I don't want to just cut this. I'm going to tear. And you want that kind of uneven edge like this. I'm going to put this one down there. I'm not sure exactly which bit I'm going to use, but I do want a nice selection of pieces. I will get rid of this ash. I would love to put it inside, but it's just too delicate. This is one of those videos that may be a little bit messy. So we're starting off with a tip. You can work on a natural nail. You can work on an extension. I'm going to use medium speed liquid, which is clear. It's clear because then you know the difference between the colours. I'm going to lay down a little bit of colour. I'm going to lay down a bit of marble as well. I'm going to use Belgium Fountain and a little bit of metallic gold with Mega White. This needs to be really thin. It's just for colour, that's all. I'm going to pick up the white first and then dip into the gold and then the Belgium Fountain. Pop that on. And you can see why I've used these colours, because they'll match with this sort of burnt effect really nicely. Do it again here and press it out and drag through to get some marble. I'm going to use some of the gold here just for colour. You'll notice that I go into the darker colour last. It's very important when you're doing marbling. I'll show you what happens if you don't do it in that order. So you notice that I go from the white to the gold to the darkest colour. And that's what you get on the brush. Now if we do it the other way around, if we go from the darkest colour to the gold, can you see what happens to the white?
It absorbs.
It absorbs the colour, so you no longer actually have white, you have like a creamy colour. Now if you want that creamy colour, that's a cool trick to do, but that's not what I wanted. I wanted a decent separation of colour. Now I'm going to take this gold and use it more like a paint, really, to just colour this section. And you want it to be quite mottled as well, because that's going to add to the effect. So you can see that it's patchy. Messy is good. So we're going to use clear now. And then you're going to have a little look at your PCs now. I like him. I like this as well. Make that a little bit smaller. I like this, but I'm just going to tear this a little bit. So I've got my pieces. And I'm going to get some clear acrylic, pop it on, and then you're going to pick up your piece, and it will absorb the liquid. And what you need to do is gently press it into the acrylic. Going to use some tweezers to just hold that into place. And smooth over with your fingers and it will stick down. And then you're going to do the same with your other pieces. And you can place them wherever you want, really. You want everything to sort of run at an angle. What's that called? That angle.
I don't know.
Sweeping up the nail.
That's the technical term for it.
That's the technical term. You want it to sweep up the nail. The tissue one definitely sits on the nail a little bit easier. It's easier to adhere to the nail. That's enough of the burnt paper. What I'm going to do is add, because at the minute it doesn't look like really pretty, it's a nice effect, but I want to make it look a little bit prettier. So what I'm going to do is add some glitter into it, and we're going to add some blue, like a navy blue into it. I think that'll really complement the colours. We will put a bit of gold in as well. So I have here Neptune. Infinity mini glitter and Neptune Infinity chunky glitter, and then I'm going to use a little bit of bronze superfine glitter and some of the twinkle star glitter mini. Maybe some gold cracked ice mylar as well. So now we put the glitter on. I mean, that's just completely changing it. I think that blue just looks stunning with that colour combination. I'm going to encapsulate with clear. Notice I'm tipping the nail down so everything moves down the nail. It's a lot easier to control. Once that's dry, I'm obviously going to file that. So now I've filed and buffed the nail and wiped over with acetone. I'm going to top coat this now. So I'm going to top coat this with the Urban Graffiti top coat. So you can see immediately, you can really see the scorched paper inside, and it really brings out the glitter as well. I'm going to pop that into the lamp. So there you are. I hope you've enjoyed that video of me setting fire to paper and banging it in a nail. It looks pretty cool. It's a cool effect. Have a go, but please, please, please be careful. Adult supervision is needed. Okay, kids?
Where's our adult supervision?
I don't know. I thought you were mine.
No, I thought you were the adult.
Oh, no. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All the products that I've used today will be listed below. Obviously, the paper is just paper, and then the other tissue paper was just like tissue paper bedroll. And there you are. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook. Don't forget to look at us on Instagram, and also subscribe to the channel. Because I didn't know if you've heard, we have 1 million subscribers. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
You ding.
What a ding I am. Yeah.